Man, I remember the early days of the Civil Rights Movement. Walked down the street scared, didn't know what was going to happen, and now look where we are. I never thought I'd see today that this thing would get so mellow that white folks would start asking me to comment on white folk problems. I came back in from Europe last month, CNN. Mr. Gregory, you think we'll ever catch Bin Laden? I say, we. I ain't looking for him. I'm still trying to find out who my daddy is. Bob Hope, a lot of you young folks don't remember Bob Hope. Bob Hope lived to get 104. He died at 3 o'clock in the morning. AP called me, Mr. Gregory, Bob Hope just died. Can we get a comment on you? I thought he'd been dead. Then what'd you say? I said, my comment is Bob Hope's family should go to Chicago and get on their knees and kiss Jesse Jackson's feet. Because for 40 years, Jesse been yelling, keep Hope alive. And he the only comment that lived to get 104. I saw Jesse the other day. Jesse said, Brother Greg, now that Bob Hope has died, let me pray for you. How you gonna run around talking about keep Dick alive?
Dick Gregory was an influential figure in the world of comedy and activism. Born on October 12, 1932, in St. Louis, Missouri, Gregory began his career as a stand-up comedian in the 1950s. His unique style blended humor with social and political commentary, tackling issues such as racism, discrimination, and social injustice. Gregory's comedy often challenged the status quo and exposed the inequalities faced by Americans during the Civil Rights Movement. He used his platform to shed light on the struggles of marginalized communities, using humor as a tool to provoke thought and inspire change. His performances not only were entertaining, they also served as a catalyst for social awareness and activism. Beyond comedy, Gregory was deeply involved in the civil rights movement. He participated in numerous protests, marches, and sit-ins, advocating for racial equality and justice. His activism spread beyond racial issues, though, as he spoke out against the Vietnam War, nuclear weapons, and other social and political concerns. Gregory's commitment to social justice led him to run for political office. In 1968, he became the first African American to launch a major presidential campaign, representing the Freedom and Peace Party,